If there's anything that makes you feel bad about your environmental choices, it's sharing your home for a week with a Swede. This, incidentally, is all perception on my part, rather than anything the Swede said or did. But my friend from Malmö came to stay for a week and, in my mind, she merged with Greta Thunberg to be a much better version of humanity than I am. Last year I counted up the number of flights I had taken and came to the appalled realization that I had been on 31 flights in 2019. That's unacceptable. Two of them were to Malmö and back, and I was glad that Miss Thunberg was traveling by sea at the time because I didn't want to bump into her and have to explain myself to the teenage environmental campaigner. I couldn't explain myself, I had no good excuses. My friend Dan bought me wax wraps for Christmas, which you use instead of clingfilm or tinfoil to wrap your food and store it in the fridge. At the end of the wax wrap's lifespan, it is fully compostable. And I felt virtuous having these in the house, as my Swedish friend also has them in her home. The thing that really struck me, though, was how often my friends and I use our cars. Six of us got together in Finiston one evening and five of the six drove there in our personal cars, the sixth was my guest. For every festive event, a flurry of text messages went back and forth asking who was driving and who wanted to carpool. In Sweden, none of my friends' friends have cars, and this really preyed on my mind. All the wax wraps in the world are not going to balance out my car use. 26 Colombian pesos, the 2020 United Nations Climate Change Conference, is coming to the city later this year, and it cannot be overemphasized how important the event is for the city. All eyes will be on Glasgow. It's a time, also, for residents to think about how they live and what impact their choices have on the environment. The SNP-led administration is very much trying to push us in the right direction by making changes to how we can use our cars in the city centre. Introducing a low emissions zone is part of this. So is bringing in Sunday parking. Tackling car use requires two things, though: for people to buy into it and for the alternatives to be there so that they do. I talk a big game about car use. I cycle to work and to the city centre if I'm coming in for any reason other than shopping. But am I in denial about my car use? Probably. I don't cycle into the city at night for a late night film because I'm usually rushing to, firstly, get to the film on time and, secondly, too lazy to contemplate cycling home again when I've already done one cycle commute that day. If I have a shopping to do, then I'll bring the car. Again, too lazy to carry heavy bags on the bus. Or I'll drive to Glasgow Fort, where I can park for more on this story, visit the news article link.